Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today is Sunday and it is time for the Sunday message. Today's message is gonna be really hard for me because a lot happened this week. I had some dear friends, family members who have lost 3 significant people in their life, and it was a tragic accident and it actually happened last Sunday. So after my Sunday message from last week, I found out, and it's just been a whirlwind of a week. There's been so many tears and so much pain and hurt and just disbelief at why these 3 amazing people are just gone. And I am confident that they loved God so much and they love their family, and I know they're spending it in heaven right now, but just the thought of the pain that their family has to go through for the rest of their life, it's unexplainable, and it brings you back to a place in life to where you know you are nothing without God. God gives and God takes away. And I really questioned that this week, you know, like, God, why? And why 3 people in 1 family? Like, why would you do that to the family? And why do they have to go through this? And why do they have to live the rest of their life without them? Like, it's just horrible. And my heart just couldn't take it. I just can't seem to grasp what God is doing and what plan he has for the ones who are left behind and had to go through seeing their loved ones pass away. Like, I don't even know how much pain and suffering and hurt we can go through before we break. And God knows best, but it was just so hard this week. It was such a hard week. So if you could just please be praying for the family and friends that have lost the loved ones. And I know that people lose their loved ones every day on a daily basis, and it just hurts my heart so much to think that people go through this every day. And so I really wanted to keep it simple this week and just count your blessings and hug the loved ones around you. And I really wanted to go a little bit deeper into that, and my mom and I were talking about living each day like it's your last, but also treating other people like it's their last day too. And if you do that and truly love others like it's their last day, you know, if it is their last day, you won't have any regret. You'll know that you loved them, and you know that you didn't have any resentment and hate towards them. I'm gonna read you this scripture really fast, and it just talks about, you know, loving people and loving your enemies, and not just the people around you, but everybody you come in contact with. If you love those who love you, what benefit is that to you? For even sinners love those who love them. And even if you do good to those who do good to you, what benefit is that to you? For even sinners do the same. And if you lend to those from whom you expect to receive, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners to get back the same amount. But love your enemies and do good and lend, expecting nothing in return. And your reward will be great, and you will be sons of the Most High, for he is kind to the ungrateful and the evil. Be merciful, even as your Father is merciful. That scripture just means so much to me right now, because I see people on a daily basis, and a lot of the times people are not very nice and they're rude, and we forget to love our enemies and we forget to love the ones who persecute us. Life is so short, and just to miss out on the opportunity to love someone who may never have received love or may never have felt love their whole entire life, you know, for you to be the one to love them, it's just huge. And even though they might seem like an enemy, God loves them so much, just like he loves you. And we are all equal, and none of us are worthy of anything more than the other, because we are all God's children. The next scripture I want to read is what my pastor talked about today at church. And he was talking about relationships when he said this, but I think you can really put this into play with anybody in your life. And words are so powerful. And just to be cautious of what you say to people and what you speak to people, because either your words will lift somebody up or tear them down. And so just to remember to just always be careful of what you're saying to people, because it is so much power in your words. Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about such things. What you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, practice these things, and the God of peace will be with you. So it's really talking about a positive mindset and to always focus on the good things in life and not to let the bad things overtake you. And I really want to put that into play with people. Like, if you have a family member who has done you wrong, or maybe a daily basis where you argue a lot and fight a lot, just to think about the good qualities in them versus the bad qualities, and it'll start to uplift them and you'll start to love them even more. So if you're having a hard time loving someone close to you or far away, away from you. Start to think about the good and true and honorable and positive things that they are. Your love for them will change. It'll grow even more than you could have imagined. And here's the last one that kind of goes along with that. And it says, be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ forgave you. And that one just hits so hard for me because I want to love others and forgive others like Christ did for me. And I know I haven't been perfect my whole life and I make mistakes all the time on a daily basis, and God chooses to forgive me and love me anyway. And that is what we have to do in life. We have to forgive others and love others regardless of what they've done to us. I'm not saying to let them keep hurting you or to be close to them in a way to where they can hurt you and it messes your life up with God. I'm not saying that, but I'm saying from a distance, even if you have to love them and forgive them, just know that you are right in your heart and that your heart is clean and pure and there's no bitterness or hate towards anyone. All right, so that completes the Sunday message for today. I really hope you enjoyed this. I hope you have an amazing week and that you don't take people for granted in your life. And I pray that you can just love them in a new way. And also just remember to love your enemies, because God loved us when we were imperfect, and we are still imperfect, and He still loves us. So I hope you guys have a great week, and just remember that all week long to just hug people and love people no matter who they are, no matter where they came from. Just love them because they are your brothers and sisters in Christ, and we are all created equal. I love you all so much, and I will see you guys in my next video. What a way to go.